on Indian Penal Code. Let us discuss the provisions of Section 153 of the IPC. What it provides? Wantonly giving provocation with intent to cause riot. What do you mean by wantonly? Wantonly means deliberately. Deliberately giving provocation with intention to cause riot. If a riot may be committed, if not committed. So when somebody deliberately, intentionally, knowingly, whoever intentionally, whoever malignantly or wantonly, by doing anything which is illegal, he does act which is illegal, and thereby some provocation is there. Provocation to any person intending or knowing it to be likely that such provocation will cause the offense of rioting to be committed. Does any person deliberately does an act or malignantly does an act, the illegal act which grips provocation to any person intending, that is, person intending or knowing to be likely that such person provocation will cause the offense of rioting, if committed, shall be punished, shall, if the offense is rioting committed in consequence of such provocation, be punished with imprisonment either discipline for a term which makes 2 to 1 year, or with fine, or with both, and if the offense of rioting being not committed, with imprisonment either discipline for a term which makes 10 to 6 months. Section 153A. Promoting enmity between different groups on ground of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, etc. Sometimes a person promotes enmity between different groups. Say for on the ground of religion, on the ground of place of birth, somewhere is a different part of India. So thereby some enmity is promoted. So or what are those grounds? Promoting enmity between different groups on grounds of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, etc. And doing acts prejudicial to maintenance of harmony. Maintenance of harmony, peace is required. That is of 653. So what is said, whoever by words, either spoken or written, either by speaking words, or by writing, or by sign, or by visible representation, or by sign, or by visible representation, what is, or otherwise, promotes or attempts to promote, on grounds of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, caste, or community, or any other grounds whatsoever, is very important. But promotes disharmony or feeling of enmity. Whoever by the words, either speaking words, spoken words, or written words, or by sign, or by any visible representation, which can be seen, or otherwise, or by any other mode, promotes or attempting to promote, on grounds of religion, race, place of birth, residence, language, caste, or community, or any other ground whatsoever, disharmony or feeling of enmity, hatred or ill will between different religious, racial, language or regional groups, or caste or communities, or B, commits any act, not promoting, commits any act which is prejudicial to the maintenance of harmony between different religious. It does an act which is prejudicial, which will cause harm to the harmony between different religious, racial, language, or regional groups, or caste or communities, and which disturbs or is likely to disturb the public tranquility, or organizes any exercise, movement, drill, even doing a drill, or other similar activity, intending that the participation in such activities shall use or be trained to use criminal force. In such drill activities, their criminal force will be used, or violence, intending such criminal force or violence, or knowing it to be likely that the participants in such activity will use or be trained to use criminal force or violence, or participants in such activity intending to use or train to use criminal force or your criminal force or violence, or knowing it to be likely that the participants in such activity will use or be trained to use criminal force or violence against any religious, then racial, language or regional group or caste or community, and such activity for any reason whatsoever, any reason whatsoever is very important, whatsoever causes or is likely to cause fear or alarm or feeling of insecurity amongst members of such religious, racial, language or regional group, caste or community, shall be punished with imprisonment which may extend to 3 years or with fine or with both. This is section 153A. That is, or this is promoting enmity between two religions, two groups or different groups. On what ground? On the basis of, on the grounds of religion or even place of birth, race or language or whatsoever. So that is punishment. Offense committed in place of worship. Whoever commits an offense specified in subsection 1, that is bringing this enmity or commits any act which is prejudicial to the maintenance of harmony between two different religions, if he commits such act in any place of worship, in any place of worship, or in any assembly engaged in the performance of religious worship, any assembly, suppose somewhere there is a religious assembly, they are engaged in a religious activity, whoever does an act, there will be enmity between two groups on the ground of religious, etc. Worship shall be punished with imprisonment which may extend to 5 years and shall also be liable to fine. 153A, punishment for knowingly carrying arms in any procession or organizing or holding or taking part in any mass drill or mass cleaning with arms. This is sometimes, there is prohibition by the state government for carrying arms. That is, only restriction is there, that is, some arms can be taken in a particular religion, that is Sikh persons. But here section 153A provides, whoever knowingly carries arms in any procession, organizes or holds or takes part in any mass drill, any procession which is organized or takes part in a mass drill or mass training with arms in any public place, carries any public place in contravention of any public notice or order issued or made under section 144A of the Criminal Procedure Code. Under section 144 of the A of the Criminal Procedure Code, an executive magistrate can pass order prohibiting a person to carry arms in a procession, etc. If such an order is there, whoever knowingly carries arms in any procession, organization, any holds or takes part in any mass drill or mass training with arms in any public place, that is violating the notice issued under section 144A. So here CRPC shall be punished with imprisonment for either description, which may extend to for a term. Not either description is not here, only imprisonment for a term which may extend to 6 months and with fine which may extend to 2000 rupees. Then 153B, imputing assertion prejudicial to national integration. It is also included by amendment. What it says? When somebody makes an imputation or some assaults or which is prejudicial to national integration, that is punishable. Whoever by words, either spoken or written, always words, either spoken, written or signed or by visible, four things you have to mark. Words, either spoken, written, signed or visible imprisonment. Four things. Depredation or otherwise also there, but makes or publishes any imputation concerning any persons imputing something, concerning alleging something, making that any class or persons cannot by reason of their being member of any religion, a particular class of person, because they are member of religion, racial, language or regional group or caste or community, bear true faith and allegiance to the concern of India. Whoever makes an imputation, publishes an imputation, that a particular person, by reason of that a class of person, not that any class of person, not a particular person, but a class of person, they are not, allegiance to concern of India, as by law established, or uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, because they are of a such religious person, such racial person, such, because he is speaking of a particular language, he is not a faithful to Krishna, or he cannot, he will not uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, or asserts, counsels, advises, propagates, or publishes that any class of persons shall, by reason of their being a member of any religion, a particular class of person, because of his particular of religion, or racial, language, or regional group, or caste community, be denied or deprived of their right as citizen of India. If such a assertion, whoever asserts, or makes or publishes any assertion, counsels, plea, or appeal concerning the obligation of any class or person by reason of their being members of any religious, racial, language, or regional group, or caste, or community, and as such, assertion, counsel, plea, or appeal causes or is likely to cause disharmony, or feeling, or enmity, or hatred, or ill will between such members and other persons, shall be punished with the imprisonment, which may extend to 3 years, and will both fine. Whoever commits an offence specified in subsection 2, 1. What are those subsection 1 we discussed earlier? By words, spoken, written, or signed, or visible representation. What if he makes and publishes that a particular person, as he will be a particular religion, or a particular class of person, particular language speaking person, he is not faithful to the concern, he will not uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, or even if he advises to another, that if, because if some persons of a particular religion, particular caste, they should be denied or deprived of their right as citizens. So here, in such case, whoever commits an offence specified in subsection in any place of worship such an offence is committed, or in an assembly engaged in the performance of religious worship or religious ceremonies, shall be punished with imprisonment, which may extend to 5 years. 154. Owners or occupiers of land on which an unlawful assembly is held. Here in this case, though a person has a duty on whose land an unlawful assembly is held, he has a duty to give information to the police. So what is this? Whenever any unlawful assembly or riot takes place, the owner or occupier of the land upon which such unlawful assembly is held or such not is committed, and any person having or claiming an interest in such land, shall be punishable with fine not exceeding 1,000 rupees if he or his agent or manager, knowing that such offence is being or has been committed, or having reason to believe it is likely to be committed, do not give an earlier notice thereof in his or their power to the principal officer at the nearest police station. If a person knows that on his land there is likelihood of commission of unlawful assembly or rioting, he has a duty to give information to the police. If he doesn't give that the earliest information, he is liable for punishment. And do not, in the case of his or their having reason to believe that it was about to be committed, even if he doesn't use any all means in his or their power to prevent it, and the event of his taking place, if he do not use all lawful means is or their power is writing unlawfully, then that is also punishable. What is? That is taking place, that is the place where an unlawful assembly is committed, or a writing is committed, there is likelihood of commission of an unlawful assembly or writing, or if it doesn't take all action to prevent such this writing, etc., then that is, he is liable for that. But he says, whenever any unlawful assembly or riot takes place, the owner or occupier of the land upon which such assembly is held or such riot is being committed, and any person having or claiming an interest in such land, shall be punishable with fine not exceeding 1,000 rupees. That is punishable with fine up to 1,000 rupees. Liability of person for whose benefit right is committed sometimes, for the benefit of somebody, a right is committed. In such case, whenever right is committed for the benefit or on behalf of any person, for the benefit of a person, a right is committed on behalf of a person who is the owner or occupier of any land respecting which such right takes place. If that person is the occupier or the owner of the land for which a right takes place, or who claims any interest in such land, or in the subject of any dispute which gives rise to the writing, or any dispute there is a writing, or who has accepted or derived any benefit therefrom. Because of such writing, somebody derives some benefit therefrom. Such person shall be punished with fine if he or his agent or manager having reason to believe that such right was likely to committed, or that the unlawful assembly by which such right was committed was likely to be, shall not respectively use all above lawful means in his or their power to prevent such a right from taking place, or for supporting and dispersing the same. He will be punished with fine. Such person shall be punished with fine. Fine amount is not there. So what is this section 156? Liability of agent, of owner or occupier for whose benefit right is committed. Similarly, for benefit of a person when a right is committed, then whenever right is committed for the benefit or on behalf of any person who is the owner or occupier of any land, respect of which such right takes place, or who claims any interest on such land, or in the subject of any dispute which gives rise to the right, or which has accepted or derived any benefit because of such right, or the agent or manager of such person shall be punished with fine if such agent or manager, having reason to believe that such right was likely to be committed, or that the unlawful assembly by which such right was committed was likely to be, shall not use all means in his power to prevent such writing. Fine amount is not there, that is only fine that is left to the court. Section 157 provides harboring person hired for an unlawful assembly. Whoever harbors, receives or assembles in any house, person receives any person in house, harbors, assembles in any house or premises, in his occupation or charge or under his control, any person knowing that such person have been hired, engaged or employed, or are about to be hired, engaged or employed to join or become member of an unlawful assembly, shall be punished with imprisonment either the same for a term which may extend to 6 months or with fine. 158, being hired to take part in an unlawful assembly of right, whoever is engaged, Section 159 is very important provision. Sometimes we get a question, what is AFRE? AFRE means when two or more persons, if you know, two or more persons fight in a public space, disturbing public peace. What it says? What AFRE has been defined, section 159? When two or more persons, by fighting in a public place, disturb the public peace, they are said to commit an affray. So what is affray? Two or more persons by fighting in a public place, when two or more persons by fighting in a public place disturb the public peace, they are said to commit an affray. So here, what is public place? Public place means where public has a right to go, enter. suppose on village, village on danda or on a road, any field which is the public place. So must be a public place. Even on a private place, two or more persons fight, and then that will not, the offense of affray will not be that will attracted. What he says, two or more persons by fighting in a public place disturbs the public place, then only they are said to commit an affray. This is also offense against public tranquility. Punishment for committing affray: whoever commits an affray shall be punished with imprisonment for either discretion for a term which may extend to 1 month. It would be very important. 1 month only. Sometimes you overlook and 6 months you say, or with fine which may extend to 100 rupees. 1 month, 100 rupees, or with both. Now, this chapter IX of offenses by relating to public servant, that has been deleted. That is from section 161. That is public servant taking gratification or that has been deleted. Because by after passing of the Prevention of Corruption Act, these sections have been deleted. Then taking gratification, that has been deleted. Taking gratification for personal influence with public servant, these sections have been deleted up to section 165A. But 166 says, public servant disobeying law with intent to cause injury to any persons. So what? When a public servant, whoever being a public servant, who is a public servant that has been defined, knowingly disobeys any direction of the law. The law has given direction to a public servant to act as to the way in which he is to conduct himself. Law always, so suppose there is a law that a particular public servant will conduct himself as such public servant in a particular manner, but he disobeys that law knowingly. Knowing is very important. Knowingly. Intending to cause or knowing it to be likely that he will by such disobedience cause injury to him. Intention is that by disobeying, knowingly disobeys any direction in law which is bound to follow which in his conduct himself as a public servant and with intention to cause injury or harm to some person that will by such disobedience cause injury or harm shall be punished with imprisonment, simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year or with fine with both. 166A, public servant disobeying direction under law. Whoever being a public servant is that the section probably 21, you find that is a detailed definition, that is definition 12 categories of persons are treated as public servant. Public servant has been defined. So what section 166A says, whoever being a public servant knowingly disobeys any direction of the law which prohibits him from requiring the attendance at any place. Suppose a public servant is prohibited to go to a particular place for the purpose of investigation into an offense. The police officer, suppose, cannot enter into a house or in a particular place without search warrant, or that is if a woman is there. So what it says? Whoever being a public servant knowingly disobeys any direction of the law which prohibits him from requiring the attendance at any place, which prohibits his attendance at any place of any person for the purpose of investigation into an offense or any other matter, which or knowingly disobeys to the prejudice of any person any other direction of the law regulating the manner in which he shall conduct such investigation. There is a direction that the particular public servant will conduct investigation in particular manner. He knowingly disobeys, fails to record any information given to him under subsection 1 of section 154 of the Code of Criminal Procedure Code. Here you see, when a person, that is, what is section 154? That is FIR, first information. Whenever a report discloses a cognizable offense, the police officer has no other option but to register it. That has been settled in the famous case on the Honorable Supreme Court in Lilavati case. That is Lilavati case that has been settled that police officer is bound to register a case. The police officer, once the report reveals the commission of a cognizable offense. Now, that has been inserted, this what, it provides that is 30. This amendment has been made in the IPC, which came into force from 3/2/2013. What it says? Whoever a publisher fails to record any information given to him under subsection 1 on section 151, if a cognizable offense is, they are bound to register again in relation to, but here relates to cognizable offense punishable under section 326. But this type of offenses, if a public servant fails to register a case under section 326A, 326B, 354, offense against women, and 354B, 370, section 370A, 376, 376A, 376B, 376C, 376D, these are rape cases, shall be punished with rigor for a term which shall not be less than 6 months, but which may extend to 2 years. Now a police officer is liable for punishment if fails to record any information given to him for offense against women, such as section 354, 326A, that is probably acid attack, 326A, 370, trafficking a person, 326A, what is that? That is voluntarily causing grievous hurt by use of acid. Whenever a report is given to the police officer is bound to register a case. If he is also bound to register a case, disclose a cognizable offense that has been settled in Leelapathy, famous case, that is Leelapathy case by the Honorable Supreme Court. That is the case still it is governing the subject. So here section 166A provides, if a police officer fails to record, not intention, simply omission, to record any information given to him under any of these sections, that is this rape offenses, this grievous, that acid attack case, the outraging modesty of a woman, so in such case, he shall be punished with imprisonment, which shall not be less than 6 months. The rigorous imprisonment, not simple, only a rigorous imprisonment, which shall not be less than 6 months, but which may extend to 2 years, and shall also be liable to fine. Because here, this offense is now punishable, and the police officer is liable for punishment. 166B, punishment for non-treatment of victim, even sometimes in accident cases, or in some offenses, when a victim goes to the police station and to the medical officer, he refuses to treat. So in such case, that is also punishable under section 166B. Punishment for non-treatment of victim, whoever being in charge of a hospital, even a public hospital, private doctor, whether run by the central government, state government, or local bodies, whether that hospital is run by central government, state government, local, or any other person, even a private hospital, contravenes the provision of section 357C of the Code of Criminal Procedure, shall be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year, or with fine, or with both. 357C, you go through what is 357C. 357C says, what all hospitals, public or private, whether run by the central government or the state government, local bodies or any other person, shall immediately provide the first aid or medical treatment free of cost to the victim of any offense covered under section 326A, that is acid attack, 376, that is rape, and rape 376, all offenses of rape, even, and shall immediately inform the police of such incidents. These are the provisions in section 357 of the C of the Criminal Procedure Code. So now this, to what it provides, that is 166B says, whoever being in charge of a hospital, public or private, you should remember all these things. If you know it, sometimes this section will come to your use. If a person who is in the charge of a hospital or a public or private hospital, he omits to provide treatment to the victim in acid attack case, rape cases, he shall be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year, or with fine, or with both. Now, these are offenses against public servant. by that is by public, by the public servant, not against by public servant. 167 public servant framing an incorrect document with intent to cause injury. Sometimes a public servant, he creates false, makes a false document to cause injury to somebody. Suppose a revenue officer, he prepares an incorrect document. Even survey settlement officer, he prepares an incorrect document. That means even while preparing a electoral roll, even preparing BPL list, he prepares an incorrect document. He is also liable for punishment. Whoever being a public servant and being as such public servant, charged with the preparation or translation of any document, who has been charged for preparation of document, translation of document, or electronic records, and frames, prepares, or translates that document or electronic records, even translation is made, in a manner which he knows or believes to be incorrect. He prepares a document, makes a document, prepares an electronic record. He knows that it is incorrect, intending thereby to cause or knowing it to be likely that he may thereby cause injury to any person. His intention is that by making such incorrect document will cause any injury to any person, shall be punished with imprisonment by the description for a term which may extend to 3 years or with fine, with both. Public servant unlawfully engaging in trade. Sometimes public servants are prohibited to engage in trade as per their this service rule. Suppose a public servant is a person, whoever being a public servant and being legally bound as such public servant not to engage in trade. If his service condition, this government servant's conduct rule provide that he cannot do any trade. If he knowingly, if a person and being legally bound to as such public servant not to engage in trade, engages in trade, shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year or fine with both. Public servant unlawfully buying or bidding for property. There is a provision that in Transport of Property Act, and then that in Evidence Act also, we find probably in Transport of Property Act, there is a provision that a court officer cannot take part in sale. So what it says, whoever being a public servant and being legally bound as such public servant, not to purchase or bid for certain property, is prohibited to purchase, bid from property, purchase or bids for that property with either in his own name or in the name of another, or jointly, or in shares with others, shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years or with fine or with both. And the property he purchased shall be confiscated. Personating a public servant. If a person is not a public servant, he is personating himself as a public servant. Whoever pretends to hold any particular office as a public servant, he pretends, knowing that he does not hold such office. A person knows that he doesn't hold such office, but he pretends to, pretends to hold any particular office, knowingly that he doesn't hold that office, or he falsely personates any other person holding such office, and in such assumed character, does or attempt to do any act under color of such office, shall be punished with imprisonment for either description or for term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine or with both. Now, this is section 171, wearing garb or carrying token used by public servant with fraudulent intent. Somebody wears police dress with a fraudulent intention, so that somebody other will believe that he is a police officer. So that is punishable under section 171. Whoever not belonging to a certain class of public servant, a person is not a particular class of particular person, wears any garb or carries any token resembling any garb or token used by that class or public servant, resembling any garb or token used by that public servant, with the intention that it may be believed, or with the knowledge that it is likely to be believed, wearing garb or carrying a token with an intention that it will be believed that he belongs to that class of public servant, shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 3 months, or with fine which may extend to 200 rupees, or with both. So by this we have completed this chapter, the offense by public servant. In the next class we will deal the chapter IXA of offenses related